What's up, it's Krit. I'm down in Miami, Florida, visiting my family. I've got someone very special I want you to meet, so come with me.
Hello everybody, my name is Sarona Snuka, also known as Tamina Snuka. I'm a WWE Superstar Women's Wrestler. Bulavinaka, Talofa Lava, this is our family, so come on in!
Hey!
Christian, start doing the onions and the garlic.
I got you.
We got our family over here, Mileta, Maleata, Auntie Atta, let's call her Tina Matua.
When in life was it, did you decide like, damn, you know, I want to smash girls' head together for a living? When did that happen?
I feel like I was born to do this, to actually wrestle, because I think at a very young age, that's when I actually fell in love with it. We were able to go to the wrestling matches, you know, and watch my father wrestle along with other family members.
Because of course, who's your father?
My father is Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Oh, hello. Shout out.
Fiji Islands.
15 feet high. Oh my God.
What exactly is a generational wrestler and what does it mean to be a generational wrestler?
It's a true blessing to be a generational wrestler and to be able to carry on the legacy of what my father has paved the way for me to do. It's a lot on your shoulders to have to try to carry on that tradition and that love, but it's one of those things that if you don't have the heart to do it or the passion, it doesn't work the way you need it to work. I mean, you gotta love this. You know, you gotta be able to love what you do, and that's what happened. Was I got bit with the bug? Pretty early on.
So it's a big honor, but it's also a big responsibility.
It sure is. You know, that's why they say, you know, when you're a generational wrestler, you know, a lot of people say, well, it's a lot more easier for you to get in because so and so did this, and so was one of the top wrestlers beforehand, and it's not true, because you know, you could be anyone's daughter or son, and you could be like the most unathletic, like uncharismatic person ever, and not be able to shine and do what it is you need to do to be able to be in this industry.
Yeah.
One thing though about professional wrestling today, at least how I feel about it too, is that it is in the family. I've been around it now for over 60 years, and it has remained in the family.
Oh, 60 years.
60 years.
Did you guys hear that? 6 years!
It's become part of our history.
Yep.
And so, very, very proud of Sarona. I know your parents are very proud of you, and your siblings are all proud of you, as we are too.
Thanks, Auntie. There you
What does it mean to be a WWE Superstar Woman Wrestler?
Oh man, along with the pressure and all like stress and all these things that have to go into it, it's something I would never change for. Like, this is what I love to do. Music hits, you're having like the butterflies and it's like crazy. You're just, that adrenaline's going as soon as you hit out there. And for me, of course, I play a heel, which is a bad person. For them to like sit there and boo you and do that type of thing, that makes sense.
That's what it's about, right?
It's like the best thing ever, or to be able to get it at the end of the match when they're actually 1, 2, 3 and they're cheering so happy, like they're so happy that whoever it is beat me at the time, that's what makes me happy. Because then we did our job to sit there and say, wow, all right, this is awesome, this is great. We got you.
How do you manage being a mother with being a wrestler?
You know, I had two little ones at the time who were, I mean, just getting into preschool and kindergarten, and I was trying to finish up some type of schooling that I could do, you know. To anybody else, it's like you're being like a single mom at the time, you're going to school, your kids are just now going to school, being a janitor, and then you kind of have that whole mentality, man, no, I think it's time for you to try to pursue something. And I have a really good support system, and I'm really great friends with their dad, and he helps me out a lot too. I think that's what mainly drives me and what drove me to kind of really push to be like, no, let me live my dreams, because not only am I doing it for myself, but I'm also doing it for my girls. I guess that's why they always say in life, it's like the decisions you make really affects not only just yourself, yep, but those who come after you, yeah, you know? So I guess that's why I'm also really grateful for what my father did for me in the sense of, yeah, I'm a generational wrestler, but now I get to sit here and pass it on to whoever and be that example for others around the world.
Yeah. So. Have either of the girls shown an interest in carrying it on?
I don't know.
Definitely.
Yes.
College.
Christian, what are you asking? Chris, wait, Christian's asking. He's asking if that an onion, Auntie.
Anyway, let's get back to
it. So we want you guys all know that this is an onion.
To remember, Christian.
And this is a garlic.
Yes.
That's a. Hey. Well, what does it mean to be the first Polynesian WWE superstar woman wrestler?
Oh, snaps. Auntie actually said it. Wow.
To be the first Polynesian women's wrestler in the WWE is humbling because it is something that is much bigger than me. Because without those Polynesian warriors who put in the work, who broke down those barriers, who battled in the ring before me, there would be no Tamina Snuka. So when I put in the work and when I step in the ring, I always do my best to honor that tradition. But it is always my responsibility to take it to the next level, to pave the way for future Polynesian women.
But yeah, you can still feel the adrenaline of when Vince and them were like, okay, yeah, you guys are debuting tonight, yeah, you know, and it was kind of like, what? This is crazy, this is awesome, and it was, and...
That's what you're working for.
Yeah, it was like, yeah, you know, and it was like Tyson Kidd and Natalya, and it was me and the, you know, it was like the Usos and me going up against them, and at the time they're huge, like, I mean, it's kind of like, even for them too, you know, the boys, it was like, wow, here we go, here... carrying on another generation, yeah, of Polynesian wrestlers.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That's me. What's one of the biggest ways that you've seen Sarona grow in the last 7-8 years that she's been wrestling?
Let me show you something.
You gotta come with.
Oh, wait, what picture are you showing? No!
This is Sarona right here.
Yeah, the Chinese, yeah, one.
This is Sarona right here. This is cousin Dwayne right here. Sarona was very, very a shy little girl.
What do I change to see in her?
Yeah.
She can really, really kick moolies now. Again, pardon the expression, but that's how I feel.
So part of why Auntie gets really very, why this hits such a close part, yeah, is because when I told her that I was deciding to maybe think about even getting into wrestling, she was all for it. And so the process and the road that I have been on this journey, she's a huge part of it. So we're cutting up chicken thighs. We got Christian's, I think he said that's garlic and onions. And then we have potatoes, and then we got our curry mixture over there. This was a family tradition. My dad loves to eat when he used to come off the road all the time, so my mother always used to cook curry all the time and make us sit there in the kitchen, and that's how I learned how to do it, was because she would always make me come over there and cook curry with her.
All right.
Cheers. What is your signature move?
My dad did teach me how to do the Superfly Splash, and so definitely that's my number one go-to, the Superfly Splash. I love doing the super kick is like, that's my like icing on the cake right there. Now that's like my everything go-to, is like that super kick. I love hitting that.
All right, thank you so much. One last cheers.
Thank you, Krit, and thank you, Coconut. Love y'all, beautiful people.
Boom!